We know that buying fuel is never going to be the highlight of anyone's day, but we want to try to make that journey a little bit more pleasurable and be able to do some things quickly and efficiently. So being able to top up, get a car wash, do some things that they want, store items that can do multiple things. So it helps them get on with their day and do the things that they want to do. We found very interesting in looking at our transactional information as well, that about 35% of our customers are fuel only, meaning they buy only fuel. They fill up and they go. And over half of all of our transactions are convenience store, whether it's store items or a service that they get, like a car wash at our site. The thing that did surprise us is that what most customers that we talked with, that going to a service station was full of anxiety. If we can lessen that anxiety at our site and give the services that they want, that makes a difference in how we go to market and the things that we offer. And those areas that we really need to focus on to ensure that customers are getting some satisfaction out of the journey that they share with us. And so what we did is we boiled these down. We have four promises that we made to customers as a result to this information and the data we collected. And it's really trying to help treat customers like they're our guests. We want to make sure stations are clean and bright, that everything's working, that we're treating and welcoming customers when they come in, and the grounds and the services are actually well maintained. So those are how we take some of the information and the data and we actually put it into work and measure and remeasure and remeasure. And yes, our stations do, if they fail after so many of these shops that we have, there's actions that are taken, and even as much as termination, because we really don't want a site that is not servicing customers the way we'd like. The theme that runs through this is everything we do at Shell has to be customer focused. The business has transformed so much since I started. And these are some of the things that we're trying to do. Since we've started incorporating the information and embedding the customer centricity, I'll call it, and using information from the various techniques that we've put in and how we actually build and the services that we offer at our sites, they're making a difference in our profitability. So it's been a fantastic and fun journey with it just really the tip of the iceberg.
So you're in the partnership business, but I guess you have to quite jealously guard your data.
Oh, sure.
In terms of ownership and getting access to it. And
we do, yeah. And in fact, we spend a lot of time on that. And it's, you know, what we find is that there are threats out there. I mean, if you look at data security, data privacy, there's all kinds of, I think they're giving us the sign, is that right, to wrap up? Making sure we have robust systems that are tested and then the size, because it's just massive amounts of data. We have to be able to churn through that data quickly. So making sure that that's all, in thinking forward. It's not just about what we do today, but with the information that we're getting and the types of information that we're getting, we need to be able to. I think that's the one thing what we've learned. Trial and error, trial and error, trial and error. Just keep doing it. And with the digital environment that we're in, and we have an opportunity to do that and do it quickly and learn from that. So.
Okay. Thank you, Carolyn.
Great. Thank you. I really enjoyed
Wonderful.
It. Yeah. Thank you. And I'll be around, guys, so if anybody wants to talk.